now be the new coach of Ikorodu United. They named today on their Twitter handle, official Twitter handle, Ikorodu United, that Okodu will no longer be the coach. Wow. He's a new Dutchman.
I've looked at this Ikorodu United could bring Mourinho. They still have a lot of things to do. The players need to psych themselves. The players need to understand that they are no more playing in the NNL, that they are playing top-flight football now. I think they need to bring more players into this team.
Is it the case of the manager or the players?
The players. For me, I've watched this team. When the Okodu was trying to get results,
well, Okodu put in some fresh legs.
But Okodu was always saying that they are inexperienced. He keeps saying it, that look, these guys still have a lot of work to do. So even mentally, they are yet to believe.
What magic is this Dutchman going
to
do?
That's why I'm trying. That's why I'm waiting to see, because I mean, there's nothing he can do. He can just bring his style or bring finesse.
But 12 games at the end of the season, only what magic
they cannot do,
is this Dutchman bringing to the team?
Yes, he's joining a team that is
almost gone.
At the lowest ebb. You know, look at the position of Ikorodu United. How many matches have they won? You know, less than 4 matches.
How far away from safety are they?
You know, I think only a miracle can save Ikorodu United. Bringing a foreign coach, yes, well, it could bring some dimension to the team, but Okodu couldn't do anything. Benson couldn't do anything. Because, you see, let's call a spade to him. The team lack quality.
Yeah.
They lack depth, and this man cannot do it. You are playing against teams that are better in terms of depth, quality, better players. And there's nothing practically anybody can do. It's like squeezing water out of stone.
Let's wait and see what magic the Dutchman will bring to the team. Let's talk about this one very quickly, guys. The League Management Company have announced sanctions on MFM and the referee. They have suggested that the referee be withdrawn from the games. Referee Alaba Abiodun from Ogun State for what they felt was a below par performance in that game. But the punishment is that MFM will play 3 games behind closed doors, and they have also been fined the total sum of 2 million naira for the way their fans invaded the pitch and breached security on Sunday at the Agege Stadium. For me, MFM first offenders, maybe good punishment.
Well, Tony, for me, the treatment of referees should be we have to be very careful. We don't hear sanctions on referees in organized crimes.
Yep.
If you are going to do it, you do it quietly to protect the sanctity of the game, so that people will not take laws into their hands. If you are sanctioning the referee, let it be a very silent issue.
Yeah.
And we should not use, I learned that referee has been doing well. Mm-hmm. We should not use one game to judge the referee, because there were overwhelming evidence. There were so much hues and cry. Should not mean that the LMC should come down heavily on that referee. I don't support that. But for MFM, simply, they didn't take charge. There were breaches of security in that game. You ask questions, how did fans encroach the pitch?
Into the technical area.
Yes, into the technical area. They are supposed to be Lagos FA and the host team being Mountain of Fire Miracle. Yeah. So I think since they are first offenders, like LMC said, let's see how it goes. They are going to play behind closed door for
three
home games and pay 2 million naira. That should serve as a deterrent to them.
Yeah, another good one for MFM, because this can look at this picture, it's not so good. You start wondering, how did these fans get into the field? You know, what if it was worse than what we're seeing now on TV? So totally unacceptable. And for a team that is trying to, find their feet on the ground, get their momentum, win games, this is going to affect them at some point. Again, I want to agree with what Oyin said. I remember when McClattenburg had that issue with Mikel. We heard a lot about Mikel and how the player was, but the referee was protected because he's definitely going to come back to the game.
Absolutely.
So you bring Alaba Abiodun next year now, and it's coming to the guys, this same referee that, and so fans are very funny. So I think the LMC, we should do more to protect our referees, knowing that the human angle of refereeing human error must come in. So I don't like that fact that the saying just go away or sometimes.
No, they are recommending that you'll be withdrawn. Let's see how that goes anyway. But I hope that these ugly things don't happen again for MFM, a club that I love to watch. I hope lessons have been learned. Let's quickly give you some results from the NNL. We couldn't do it on Monday. We couldn't do it on Tuesday as well. But let me just see if we can quickly run through it today and update you for those asking questions about the Nigeria National League and you want to get the results. Let me run through this in a minute. Jigawa Golden Stars, truly at home. The home teams have been very good. They beat Sokoto United 2-1. Mighty Jets beat Yarma Light 2-0. Kogi United beat Kaduna United 2-0. Shekarau Babes, Katsina United ended it goalless. in Division A1. In Division A2, we had Supreme Court beating Zamfara United 1-0. Wiki Feeders beating FC Taraba 1-0. Gombe United handing Kwara United their first defeat of the season 2-0. And then Dream FC hammering Adamawa United 4-1. That result is not there, but it ended 4-1 in favor of Dream FC. B1, you have Abia Comet 1-1 with Remo. Unisem Rovers 1-0 over Aqua Starlets. Delta Force 2-0 over Go Round. And then COD losing 2-0 at Prime FC of Oshogbo. In B2, all right, which is the final division, B2, let's quickly see what happens in B2. I hope that result comes on your screen. It looks like B2 is refusing to come through for us. But one trend here, guys, home teams are dominating so far. Yeah. Okay, B2, it's not coming through yet. B2 is not coming through yet. But one trend that we see here, home teams are dominating.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's how it is at the LNL. But look at that.
Okay, okay.
Yeah.
Julius Atete beating First Bank in Lagos 1-0.
Yeah.
Gateway winning 2-0 at home against Confine. Crown FC 2-0 over Bayelsa United. And then Insurance of Benin 2-0 over ABS of Ilorin. All right. So these are the results for you. NNL games played over the weekend. We'll go on a quick break. When we return from the break, we'll be spending time to talk Copa America Centenario on Sports Tonight. Join us again. Thank you for staying with us. It's time for us to move on to another part of the show. And this time we will be talking Copa America Centenario on Sports Tonight. And of course, you all know that the first semi-final game has been played. And in a few hours from now, we'll be playing the second semi-finals of the 2016 Copa America. Well, Onye Uchuajukwu, still with me on Sports Tonight. Onye, we talked about this on Monday. And it has lived up to the hype because it was the case of the host against the favorites. And when a team has a Lionel Messi, you may not lose your bet if you bet on Messi. If you bet against him, I'm sorry, you may have to lose your money. But on the night, Onye, Messi scored a fantastic free kick goal and it was smooth sailing for the Argentines. But let's start off by showing you the results in case you were somewhere else and you didn't monitor what was going on in that game between the U.S. and Argentina. It ended 1-2-3-4 to Argentina, and the Americans playing at home, no goal.
Well,
expected.
Expectedly, Tony. And the good thing is that apart from the fact that Messi was phenomenal, other players are also they are coming to the party. You know, before the little Argentina used to carry the burden of the national team on his little shoulders, but Ezequiel Lavezzi scored. Gonzalo Higuain is also scoring. You know, and other players are coming to the party, so it has made Messi's job very easy. You know, playing as a creative and as a playmaker. Mm. So for
look at that, that's the goal.
It was only going to be one-sided. Tony, I told you here on Monday. You know, the Americans were missing three key players. You know, some due to suspension and injury. So, playing against the favorites with a depleted side will only, you know, make it very, very difficult for the Americans, the host. You know, so I think it lived up to expectation and everything went on well for the Argentines. Mm. But Tony, this game also brought a lot of angle and dimension to it. You know, Messi before now equaled Gabriel Batistuta's record of 54 goals for the Argentine national team.
This is the moment. He now went ahead
and created.
Hold on. This is the moment I was talking about. The free kick. I mean, if you lined up three goalkeepers on that post, I'm not sure that ball wouldn't still go in.
Only Lionel Messi can.